Peace and blessings, family. A word. Book of Revelation. Chapter 17. Verse 8. The beast that thou sawest was and is not. The beast that thou sawest was and is not. It talks about the lady whore Babylon that is spoken. Sitting on a beast. The beast that was and is not. A lie. It's a lie. What's a lie? The beast that was and is not. Meaning, you're dealing with spiritual wickedness, evil forces. You wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness, right? Against principalities and powers, against the rules of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. The beast that was and is not. The beast that was. And is not. Spiritual wickedness in high places. Beast. Spiritual wickedness in high places. We live in a country where a lot of things given to people appear one way, but they are not. The beast that was and is not. How can you have a beast that is and is not? It was and is not. A lot of things that are going on, it doesn't matter whether you're talking about the music in this country that a lot of the young people hear. A lot of people say, oh, it's entertainment. It was, but it is not. There's spiritual wickedness in high places that there's something else inside of it. That's why you're watching a lot of young people and the evil and the negativity that's upon them. And you wonder, well, what's going on? But you live in a place where spiritual wickedness and high places is going on all around you, where something appears to be one way, but it is not. And what do I mean? I gave you an example. A lot of people live in America. They look at the Statue of Liberty. The Statue of Liberty was given as a gift to America in 1865, but when America saw what the statue actually looked like, they rejected it. What it represented. The initial statue was given at the end of the Civil War to commemorate the freeing of the enslaved people and the winning of the Civil War by the Union Army. Actually, that green statue, when you look at it, is actually a copper statue that when it came over, even though it was modeled by a Roman woman, the statue was the color of a brand new penny. America didn't want it. The statue had chains coming down out of its hands, broken chains to represent our freedom. America didn't want it. Why would France give a statue at the end of the Civil War and yet America say that the statue was commemorated? The winning of the Revolutionary War, which basically happened almost 100 years before, because the beast that was and is not. It gives you the illusion of one thing when it's actually another. And a lot of people can look at the Statue of Liberty and think, oh no, that was for the immigrants. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses. No, that was a poem added at the bottom of the statue in 1903. But the statue was given by France commemorating the freedom, the abolition of slavery for the blacks, and honoring the Union winning the Civil War. But America didn't want to have anything to do with that, so they had to alter it a little bit. There used to be a chain coming down out of its hand showing the broken shackles. As a matter of fact, if I got it right, the right foot of the Statue of Liberty is raised as though we're going forward in our liberty and in our freedom to be a better people. Who? The entire nation, but definitely the people who have been enslaved walking into their liberty. But you got to remember, it was a beast that was and is not. Well, how can you liken that to what you're saying? Because a lot of things presented to you appear one way, but they are not. They are not. You got a lot of young people right now. I'm not even going to talk about the adults. They run around with cell phones. A lot of people would say that makes better communications. No. You got students that are uneducated, although you're on a cell phone all day. What appears to be one way is not. And many people, I mean, we get so many things in our history books making us think, well, this the Statue of Liberty is at Ellis Island. That's about the immigrants. No. It's about the forced immigration of a people who had gained their freedom, but they changed it. They wouldn't accept it unless it was altered. As a matter of fact, like I said before, the green patina that's on the Statue of Liberty is oxidation. If you saw the Statue of Liberty when it was originally brought here, it looked like a shiny brand new copper penny. The beast they was and is not. Was and is not. Something that depicts itself. It wasn't like the land of the free, home of the brave. It was, and it's not. Here is a country that's 5% of the world's population and yet has 25% of the world's prisoners held in its prison. The land of the free, it was, and it's not. You have to look at when it talks about the beast. And I thought, Lord, what is the beast? The beast is an unholy lie. Spiritual wickedness in high places. Understand how deep this thing really goes. Book of Ephesians says, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world. Spirits. Most of us, brothers and sisters, sometimes this situation gets so strong, so crazy, that we can start feeling lost. We can feel outside ourselves. That's why he shortened the days of his coming. Because if he didn't, no flesh would be saved. His elect. He did it for his elect's sake. Why? Because the Spirit of God knew this thing is so out of control that if he didn't intercede, a lot of us right now are struggling. Some of us start feeling lost because of the madness going on. Why? Because it was and it's not. Some things are made to appear one way when you know they are not. They are not. You can talk about the inception of this country. George Washington, supposed to be the father of freedom, Lord have mercy, the man had almost 400 slaves. He was and was not. It's a beast. It's a spiritual wickedness in high places. It's spiritual wickedness in high places. It's a beast. It's a beast. You don't think spiritual wickedness is a beast? And you can see the face of the beast, and sometimes it appears to be something. It is not. It is not. You can watch the Hollywood lie machine depict everybody as one nation other than what they really were. Why? Because it was what? It was put out there that way. But it is not. It is not. And even when you look at the things we see every day or depicted to us or told to us or ran down to us as having one particular meaning, actually have a completely different. You can Google up the Statue of Liberty, and first it will tell you it was commemorating the Revolutionary War. On the tablet, it says July 4, 1776. But you got to remember, this thing was given. This sculptor in France, he told America he wanted to give them this statue in 1865. America said, that's to commemorate the Revolutionary War. No. It was the year of the end of the Civil War. It wasn't about immigrants. It was about abolition of slavery. But America wasn't going to put some gigantic statue commemorating black people's freedom in the harbor in New York City. Here's something funny. At the bottom of the feet, there's still a broken chain. Most people can't see the broken chain because of how high the pedestal is that the statue sits on. Why? Because the beast was, and it's not. You represent liberty of a people that it was had nothing to do with. And yet, the people that it had everything to do with, you pretend it had nothing to do with them at all. So most people look at the Statue of Liberty and think that thing won't have to do with me. It got to do with immigrants coming in the Ellis Island. That's because it's a beast that was and is not. Everything you see, you got to flip it. You got to flip it. A lot of us think, you know what, because we got all this free entertainment now, you got the cable, you got the cell phone, you got the computer, all this stuff makes things better. It depends on how you look at it, because it's a beast that was, and it's not. Why? Because you got to look at some of the things that happened to people. Was black music good? Sure it is, still good. But you can look at some rap, I'm talking that negative, 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 and you go, you know, black music was, is good, but the way the negative music is poured out there, it is not. It is not. It's a beast. What beast? Spiritual wickedness in high places. High places. I was just thinking about the beast. Thinking about the manipulation of the truth. The beast is also the ultimate liar. To give it power, to give that whore power. A lot of people live here and go, you know, you can see that even in the country world. We're a country about freedom and God we trust. Really? All you got to do is look at the pagan weekdays. Monday, Monday, or we can go to Sunday, the celebration of the sun. That's sun worship. The days of the week are based on paganism. The beast that was and is not. Spiritual wickedness in high places. A lot of things you see that you think are one thing are actually another. And most of us are taught to lie so long, we believe it until we recognize it just deceiving because it's a beast that was and is not. Why? It was a lie that was told, manipulated, forwarded. But it has no true power. I used to read about the Puritans, thought, wow, this is a pure people. And yet, you came over here for religious freedom. You believed in the Bible. And a lot of people don't know that they think slavery only went on in the South. No. Slavery, it went on in all 13 colonies. All 13. It's just that slavery ended in the north, most northern states by the 1800s. By 1800, better spoken. 65 years later, slavery was over in the south. The beast that was and is not. So when you think of slavery, you can't just go south for the Mason-Dixon line. You gotta go all over those original 13 colonies. The beast that was, it's a lie. What do I mean it's a lie? The whole depiction is an illusion, like a matrix that makes you think things are one way when they are another. But you're told it so long, you think it's true. And it is not. It is not. A lot of us don't even know, and many of the people who look at Statue of Liberty had nothing to do with immigrants. That statement, give me your tithe, your poor, your huddled masses, that thing wasn't added until 1903. It was celebrating freedom from slavery. And the statue, initially, it was copper colored. Only through oxidation did the patina turn bluish green. They'll tell you now that they shouldn't really clean it, because it could hurt the statue of what it really is. They clean that statue. It looks the color of many of us. Just dropping knowledge, just thinking about the beast that was and is not. It's like the history of a country that projects itself as one thing when it's actually another. The beast that was. What do you mean was and is not? You know, some people can tell a lie so long that you actually believe, but it was and is not. How can you be a land of the free when you enslave people? Either through actual slavery, the 13th Amendment was allowed you to do it through incarceration. You got other people, here's how deep slavery goes, just so you know. You got something called occupational slavery. Oh yeah, occupational slavery. You go to work, you get taxed, get your boots taxed off of you. You try to live and do those things that you're supposed to do, and yet you're always chasing the exit. And it's like a labyrinth. It's always moving. It's always shifting. Why? Because it's a beast that was and is not. You think that you're free, and you sit back and go, why am I doing this? I can watch people come in this country that never truly had anything to do with the history of this country, and yet some kind of way, according to scripture, they're allowed to start businesses and thrive and do well, and yet you're under the illusion that if you do what you're supposed to do, you can climb up too. And I'm not saying you can't, but you got to understand the beast that was and is not. You know, I read this book one time called Behold the Pale Horse. They talked about occupational slavery and occupational orphans. Yes, orphans where the kids were given to other people to raise because the parents were out there busting their behind so much that the only way that they could have a home was you had to have two people working and not one, meaning mom can't be there with the kids, somebody else is with the kids. And because these kids have not been given any moral structure, here's this beast that was supposedly a God-fearing nation that now they took morality, threw it out, and corruption seems to be the only way to go. Anything you want to do, if you can make a dollar, it seems to be okay, and the people that talk right are treated like they're wrong. Why? Because the beast that was, it's not. It's not what it appeared to be. You know, in the South, antebellum South, they used to call the men gentle men and women genteel women. And yet, the debauchery that went on at those plantations, it was a beast that was, and it's not. To appear as though you have all these manners, all this decency, and yet the debauchery that you're doing behind closed doors and really the doors ain't closed. It's just that the lie is told. Where? Spiritual wickedness in high places. High places. Brothers and sisters, it's just thought based on a truth about a beast that was and is not. Like the Hollywood lie machine. That's a beast that was. It was depicting history. But it is not. Is not what? Most of it is not true. The depictions are illusions based on something to create confusion about the fact that they want to allude to something they never were. In order to lead you away from the truth. Why? Because you got spiritual wickedness in high places. How do you know? Because there's a beast that was and it's not. And you got to see behind the veil to understand this thing we wrestling against. It's spiritual wickedness. At the same time, you can feel time just speeding up. There's so much stuff going on this earth right now. But I just recognize the beast that was. And it's not. And when you learn the history and how much the lie is told, you got movies right now where people, oh no, obviously the Statue of Liberty is for the immigrants. No, that's the lie that was told. Because they did not want to honor the truth of a people's freedom. So, it was, but it's not. What do you mean? It was depicted as something. If you dig on the history, it is not the true history of why that statue is in that harbor. And it's just something that I noticed, and I kept thinking that beast that was, and it's not. It's a spiritual wickedness. That's That's what it is. It's a spiritual weakness. That beast ascended out of the bottomless pit. Why? Because it's spiritual wickedness. And when it goes and is destroyed, it goes into perdition, thus saith the Lord. Where? In the book of Revelation. What's perdition? Total destruction. Damnation. Why? Because that lie, that spiritual wickedness, that's the thing that helps initially give that whole power. But you gotta understand, it was. And it's not. It depicted itself as this great, beautiful, honorable place. It was. But it is not. Shalom, brothers and sisters. Shalom.